KnowYourTutor.com is a one-stop platform to find best coaching institutes, tutors, and to get discount on courses.
Hi everyone, this is Rahul Puri, and I'm into UPSC preparation from last 10 years. Myself, I have given 2 interviews, and since then I'm into UPSC coaching, taking classes in Delhi and Chandigarh. So today I'm going to discuss few myths about UPSC preparation. So even when I started my preparation, I was working with Infosys before I started my UPSC preparation. We used to hold lot of myths about this preparation that we hear from here and there, and we make these kind of notions. So rather than, and then we jump into this preparation and waste our precious years of our life. So what my agenda of this video is that we should go for this a challenging exam. This is the one of the wonderful career which I can tell you that government services at this level, you will feel wonderful by joining this profession. But we should have a better idea. We should be clear. We should not start this preparation by holding these views and having ambiguities in our mind, and we jump into this preparation. So let's start with a few myths. I'm going to discuss around 10 myths about this preparation. The first and the foremost myth is when to start this preparation. This question has been come across in last 10 years. When I started, I was also thinking what's the right time. And this question, whenever I counsel anyone, so the first question is, sir, when's the right time to start? So my friends, I'll be true to you guys that trust me, there is no right time to start this preparation. I can say the sooner it is, the better it will be. If you say that justice delayed is denied, same way success delayed, you can't relish that success. So the sooner you enter into this preparation, the better it will be. And the sooner time is, if you start in your graduation days, then I can say you will save your lot of precious years with either by getting selected, or with time you will realize that this is not for you, this profession you don't want to enter. With time, might be few of them you can realize this. And the third thing, if God forbidden someone is not get into the preparation, then they have that ample of time to shift for other alternate career. So it is always better to start this preparation during your graduation days. So to have this view in your mind, the sooner you will start, if you want to enter into civil services, the sooner you start your preparation, the better it is. You can start by yourself to, let me deal in this, this with the second myth, that without coaching, according to few students, without coaching, they can't crack UPSC. See, this is the redundant view that you need coaching for this exam. I'll not say that you need coaching, that you have to go to the coaching institute and only then you can crack UPSC. More than coaching, I'll tell you guys that you need guidance. So if guidance comes from some of your seniors, if guidance comes from your in the family, if there is someone to guide you, or if this guidance can come through from mentors whom you can, for that you have to go to the coaching institute. Because without guidance, the domain of this exam is so wide that you will get deviated, and without guidance you will not, you not only need guidance, you need constant mentorship, continuous guiding you require in this exam at every level. At the length of the exam itself is, it takes years sometimes. So you need to go for pre, you need to go for mains, then it's the interview. At every level you need constant mentorship. So for that, yes, I'll say rather than coaching, it is a guidance which is more important. So look for the right guidance. So this is the second myth which I have been come across most of the time, that does coaching is required. So I'll say no, coaching doesn't, you don't require coaching if you have right guidance. Someone is there to check your answers. Someone is there to tell you how to approach pre. Someone is there to tell you what is important, which things are important. So this is what exactly is required in this exam. And third myth is the myth generally held by every student who starts UPSC preparation. That's we have heard that minimum 15 hours of study is required to crack this exam. So again, I'll tell you, this is the biggest myth being held by students, that minimum 15 hours of study is required, and we have to sacrifice our life, we have to sacrifice our enjoyment, we are not allowed to go for any other vacations. Once into UPSC preparation, you have to spend 15 hours daily. No, not at all. This is an exam which requires consistency rather than the number of hours. You need to spend around 6 to 7 hours daily under right direction. If you are consistent in your preparation, trust me, you will able to do justice with your preparation, and you can crack this exam Very soon, very early you can crack. You don't have to spend 5 to 6 years, or you have to spend 15 hours daily. This is the biggest myth. Minimum 6 to 7 hours, but with consistency, that is more important. The word is consistency. Every day you have to be consistent with your preparation. The quality of hours is important rather than the quantity of hours. So quality is more important, and that quality comes under right guidance. So then comes the fourth myth, that only toppers can crack UPSC. So this is again the myth being held by most of the students. This exams require the intelligence brains. No, this exam require average brains, but who has the determination, will, and the consistency to crack this exam. So this is more important rather than the level. IQ is something else, but this exam does not demand very high IQ. Yes, average level of intelligence is required, but other than that, you can compile different things and you can see the bird's view, the top view, from where you can relate so many things: history, polity, economy, geography, international relations, and current affairs, where you require average intelligence. But more than intelligent, it is the consistency. So this exam is not for the topper. This is for the average students who have been consistent with their studies till their graduation. Then comes the myth, excellent English is required to crack. Only convent education is must to crack this exam. No, students from humble background have shown tremendous result in this preparation. Yes, a basic level of English is required. If you have chosen the medium of your exam as English, only then English is required, that too with medium proficiency, not with very high. Vocabulary is must to crack this preparation. This is not the exam of a literature. This is the exam of UPSC, where you able to write the answers with good expression. So rather than the command over English, it is the consistency and the expression which is more important. So again, coming to the point, if you have an average command over your language, that is more than enough. If you are from a Hindi background or from any other regional background student, you can crack UPSC through your mother tongue, that is of any language which has been given in the Constitution of India. So it is not very high proficiency test of English. It is a test of something else. UPSC is not testing your English. Then comes another myth, that engineers and doctors have edge in this particular exam. This is more than myth, because they have shown, we can see by trends, students are holding this myth that engineers and doctors are getting more selected, so that's why they have an edge. Trust me, UPSC pattern is like, UPSC syllabus is like that. They do not favor students of any particular stream or branch. In fact, if you see the syllabus, it is tilted entirely towards humanities. Engineers and doctors have better, they don't have better edge syllabus wise, because they are more consistent. They have shown hard work, they have faced competitions early in their life, and they know how to channelize their preparation in a guided way. This helps them to crack this exam, and that's why the percentage that engineers and doctors are cracking this exam is increasing. Otherwise, nowhere in the syllabus, nowhere in your curriculum, that more science is coming than humanities. Entirely, it is more of humanities, which includes current affairs, history, polity, geography. Nowhere. Science and tech contains a very small portion of this exam. That too only, if I'll say syllabus, why, it is just 10% of the syllabus, that is science and technology, and that too is more about technology, which an average candidate can also understand, which covers topics like nuclear technology, defense, missile testings, computers, supercomputers, IT knowledge. So you don't have to need to know technically, you need to know more about what's going on these days. Like example is a Bitcoin. So even engineers are not very sure how Bitcoins are generating, and UPSC will never ask you the question how to mint Bitcoins. It is always about the basic information, that what is happening in the technology world. So do not hold this myth that you do not have an engineering background or medical background, then you have some disadvantage, or you lack anywhere for this preparation. No, it is nothing like this. Then comes the myth that minimum 5 to 6 years is required for this exam. And this is again a myth which has been held by the student, because students have seen, might be their seniors and others, struggling for these many years and still not able to crack UPSC. There was a dialogue in a very famous Hindi movie that tumhara UPSC exam pyar na ho gaya, tumhara UPSC exam ho gaya, 10 saal se qualify nahi ho raha. So these kind of dialogues create this myth that UPSC requires tremendous amount of hard work for so many years to crack this exam. It happens because we are not preparing according to the, because we are not preparing under right guidance and we are lacking guidance. That's why it takes so much time, because those who have done their preparation under right guidance have shown, have able to score good ranks within their first year of preparation or at max to the second year of preparation. They even don't require the third attempt to get a good rank. So that's where I'm stressing so much that it is all about right guidance. Without guidance, you will waste your precious years, because the domain of UPSC preparation is very wide, very, very, very wide. And the chances student will stress out himself or herself and not able to grasp what exactly is required. They will keep studying without realizing what the trend of UPSC pattern is. So don't waste your time. If you have decided that you want to go for UPSC, you are determined that you want to make civil services as your career, start looking for the right guidance. So channels could be many, but the prerequisite thing is the right guidance. So please start your preparation without holding these kind of myths in your mind, and take a very neutral view before starting your preparation. And the last thing, once decided that you want to go for civil services, go with full zeal. Don't think about making plan B's or plan C's and plan D's. First I'll do this, then only I can go for UPSC. First I'll do this, then only I go for UPSC. Don't do this thing. Once decided, fully channelize, fully focus on your preparation for UPSC. Give your best, and rest leave on destiny. So this is my piece of advice to all the budding candidates who want to make their civil services as a career. And trust me, this much hard work is more than worth once you get selected. Thank you. Best of luck.